Whitefish Point and 80 miles west became ominous to sailors. Shipwrecks were happening along Lake Superior Shipwreck Coast. There's no place to hide. When you round the point at Whitefish Point, you better make it to Marquette or Munising. Many ships that tried to turn around and come back for the protection of Whitefish Point just didn't make it. The basic requirements of a lighthouse are to aid navigation. The one at Whitefish Point was erected in 1849 because it marked the critical turning point for all ships entering and leaving Lake Superior. It was really the busiest lighthouse in all the Great Lakes.
The main job, of course, with the lighthouse keeper was to keep the light clean and full of fuel, and he had to make sure it was operating. When the ships are sailing around Whitefish Point, you can't see land, so it's very reassuring to see that flashing light. The lighthouse keeper would have to access the light through 70-some steps every 2 hours and 18 minutes. You had to be at the beck and call of the light.
Whitefish Point was such an important location that often anything new that came along in the lighthouse service, Whitefish Point got it. The Fresnel lenses, the submarine bell, was a wireless radio communication station, a new signaling device they wanted to use for a foghorn. In 1923, they established the first rescue station at Whitefish Point. The surfmen were young men, very fit men, and their life was one of boredom, repetition, and extreme danger when they were called out. Their slogan was, "The regulations say we have to go out, but nothing about coming back." Many surfmen lost their lives on the Great Lakes trying to aid sailors who had wrecked just offshore. In 1970, it was automated, meaning there's no personnel staying on station. They're remotely operated from Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan. In 1978, we formed the Great Lakes Shipwreck Historical Society, helping save the Whitefish Point Light Station that had been abandoned. And so in 1987, we opened this museum gallery, and since then, we've restored most of the buildings on site now. The restored surf boat house that tells the story of life-saving along Lake Superior Shipwreck Coast. No matter what the age of an individual was, it could be small children to older adults that love the story of shipwrecks and lighthouses and life-saving. It's a real human drama story. It happened right here at Whitefish Point, and this is where we're telling the story.
Produced by Michigan Television in partnership with the Michigan Council for Arts and Cultural Affairs and the Michigan Humanities Council.